Okay, this video is going to be a couple more examples of factoring a second-degree polynomial. And I'm doing these extra ones because, as I said in the previous video, you're going to see things like this all through algebra, and you really want to make sure you're comfortable with them. So the best way to get comfortable is to practice as many as you can. In fact, probably the best way to do this video would be for you to take a good look at this problem, pause the video, work it out on your own, and then continue the video and make sure you got the same answer as me. Okay, so stop the video, get a pencil and paper, work it out, and then come on back. Okay, so here we go. I've got m squared minus 11m plus 24, and I want to factor that down into two binomials. I start out with this m squared, which means my variable in both of the binomials will be an m. Next thing I want to do is look at the signs. I've got a positive sign here, so that means that both of my constants, the number part of the binomials, both of those were the same sign. Now to find out what the sign is, I'm going to look at the middle term, and that's negative. So now I know that both of my signs are negative. Next step is to actually look at the constant at the end of the original problem, the polynomial. That's a 24. So I want to think of all the different ways that I can make 24 with two numbers. In other words, what are the different factors of 24? So I could make a 24 with a 1 and a 24. Of course, there would be negative 1 and negative 24. I'm just not bothering to write the negative. But I have to be able to add them together and get to a negative 11. And since 1 plus 24 is 25, that's not going to work. So let's go on to 2. Well, 2 divided into 24 is 12. So 2 times 12 is 24. 2 plus 12 would get me to a 14. I don't want 14, I want negative 11. I can divide 24 by 3. So 3 into 24 goes 8 times. 3 times 8 is 24. 3 plus 8 is 11. So negative 3 plus negative 8 would give me a negative 11. Let's check that. Let's put that in here. This should be my solution. We'll check it by foiling it back and seeing if we get here. Always check your answers. I found in talking to students that most students lose as many points to careless errors as they do to actually not knowing how to do something. So since problems like this allow you to check your answer by working backwards, you can make sure that you're avoiding the carelessness part of your problem. Okay, so let's do that. Foiling this back, I have m times m will give me an m squared. Foiling this first times the last, or the outsides, will give me a m times negative 8 is negative 8m. The inside terms, negative 3 and m, will give me a negative 3m. And negative 3 times negative 8 will give me a positive 24. I want to combine those two terms in the middle. I'm going to have m squared. Negative 8 minus 3 is negative 11, so that's negative 11m. And the 24 remains the same. Let's check carefully. M squared minus 11m plus 24. So this factorization checks out. Okay, here's one more. I've got 4x to the third minus 16x squared minus 20x. So hopefully you're going to pause this, work it out, and then come back. Okay. Okay, now, just in case this looked too hard for you and you weren't able to figure out what to do with the x to the third and the 4 and so on, realize we can start out, if you don't have a 1 as the first coefficient, see if you can factor something out of all of the terms. And if you don't have an x squared, see if you can factor a variable out. So If that stopped you and you weren't able to finish it, pause the video now and do that part. Okay, let's go on and complete it. So I've got a 4, a 16, and a 20. They're all even numbers, so I know I could factor out a 2. I could divide them all by 2. Let's see if we can divide them all by 4. So I know I could factor a 4 out of the first term. 4 times 4 is 16, and 4 times 5 is 20, so I can factor a 4 out of everything. And while I'm at it, I see I have an x to the third, an x squared, and an x, so I know I can factor an x out. So let's see what I have left. 4x divided into 4x to the third. Well, 4 into 4 will give me a 1, and x divided into x to the third will give me an x squared. 4 divided into negative 16 will give me a negative 4, and x divided into x squared will give me an x. Then 4 divided into negative 20 will give me a negative 5, and the x's are going to cancel. So good, now I've got my second degree polynomial. So we'll factor this. Don't lose this 4x. You gotta keep writing it out as you go through the problem, because that's still one of the factors. Okay, looking at this polynomial, I've got an x squared as the first term, so that means my binomials will each begin with an x. I've got a negative sign for my third term. That means that the signs in my binomials are going to be different. One will be positive, one will be negative. And I've got this 5 here. Well, 5 is a great number because the only way to factor 5 is by a 1 and a 5. So I know I've got to have a 1 and a 5. And then the only question is, which of these numbers gets the positive sign, which gets the negative sign? So the trick I'm going to use is look at the sign in the middle, and whatever sign is in the middle, again, this works if you've got two different signs, whatever sign is in the middle is going to go to the larger of the two numbers. So this becomes a negative 5, this becomes a positive 1. And this should be my solution, 4x times x plus 1 times x minus 5. Let's check that and make sure it's right. So here's my 4x. Foiling out these two terms, I'm going to get x times x is x squared. X times negative 5 is negative 5x. 1 times x is x, and 1 times negative 5 is negative 5. I want to combine these two terms. So I'll have 4x times x squared. Negative 5x plus 1x is just negative 4x minus 5. And distributing this 4x, I have 4x times x squared is 4x to the third. 4x times negative 4x is negative 16x squared. And 4x times negative 5 is negative 20x. So I've got 4x to the third minus 16x squared minus 20x. I started out with 4x to the third minus 16x squared minus 20x. So my factorization is correct. It was this one. Okay, and I can't say this enough. You're going to see tons of problems like this as you go on in algebra. So please make sure you get plenty of practice in it, and you should be fine. Okay, good luck. See you next time.